question over the past 20 minutes as I've been up here rambling around, having fun, talking about personal accountability. How many of you have been visualizing four or five different people in your life who really needed to be in this room today to hear the message on personal? The guilt-o-meter just went skyrocketing. We are so bad. Here we got one of the most excellent groups in all of Nationwide. And we've been sitting here actually thinking how good this would be for someone else. Oh my gosh, do me a favor, turn to your left. Does that person need accountability? Go ahead and look. How about the person on your right? Do they need accountability? Have you seen blame in your organization? Sure, the CEO blames the senior VP, who blames the VP, who blames the director, who blames the manager, who blames the supervisor, who blames the employee, who blames the customer, who blames the U.S. government. The government blames the schools blame the board of education, the board blames the teachers, teachers blame the parents, parents blame the teen blames the mom blames the husband. Husband looks back at the wife and says, "Why didn't the caramel corn go overnight?" I call that the circle of blame. Do you have a circle of blame in your organization? A circle of blame. Do you have a circle of blame? Very costly. What would the circle of blame be costing us? My gosh, can you even think through that? It's never on the balance sheet what blame costs us. I mean, how many of you would get out of bed in the morning and say something like this? Today I exist to blame. I will run through life writing down the names of all the very bad people I know that have not lived up to their commitments. I will begin in my kitchen. I will ask questions like, who left the peanut butter and the bread out? Who made the mess down here? Who lost my car keys? And then I will go straight to work and I will ask questions like, who made the mistake? Who missed the deadline? Who dropped the ball? Who's not getting back to us? And I will engage not in brainstorming, but in blamestorming. Forget the brainstorming. I'll do the blamestorming. I'll ask questions that begin with who. I will wear the company coat of arms. Have you seen the company coat of arms? Yeah, it looks like this. Well, who dropped the ball? Who made the mistake? Who missed the deadline? And all of a sudden, I'm all wrapped up in this uniform, the company coat of arms. Arms crossed across my chest, fingers pointing at everybody else. Because I have chosen to focus on the who done it and not the problem itself. Guess what leaders recognize? All problems are in the past. Solutions are now. All problems are in the past. That's the only way they can exist. It already happened. So the better question is, well, the question behind the question. One that begins with what or how, and we'll get into the other guidelines in just a moment. But you see, blame is a costly thing. The opposite of blame would be what? Ownership. Ownership. I have a client in the medical industry. You know what the sales reps in the field call corporate? They affectionately call corporate this term, the sales prevention club. The sales prevention club. You know, if we didn't have corporate, we could make a lot more sales around here. They just get in our way. I had a VP years ago who proudly said to me, nope, there's no we, they syndrome here. I said, you're kidding. No we, they, no cross-functional friction, no sales versus ops, no we, they. You know what he said? Nope, there's no we, they here, but it is us against them. Anybody here ever been to a Rock Bottom Brewery restaurant? Yeah, great. I walk into the one in Minneapolis. It's noon on a Thursday. It's very busy. They put me on a bar stool because that's all they had. Young man runs by me a few minutes later carrying dirty dishes on a tray. He stops. He looks at me. He says, sir, have you been helped? And I said, no, I haven't been, but all I want is salad and bread. Well, I can get to that, sir. What would you like to drink? I said, I'll have a Diet Coke. It's my favorite, you know. He said, I'm sorry, sir. We only sell Pepsi. I said, no, thanks. I'll have water and lemon. Great. I'll be back. He's gone. 2 minutes later, he's back with the salad and the bread. I thank him. He says, you're welcome. He's gone, and I want you to know something. At that moment, I am a completely satisfied Nationwide client. I hope you get the point. In other words, he didn't need to return. He didn't need to go the extra mile. A minute later, suddenly I feel the wind of enthusiasm blown behind my back. The long arm of service stretches over my shoulder and places right next to my plate a 20-ounce bottle of Diet Coke, just what I'd asked for. I was so stunned, I just said, thank you. You're welcome, sir. He's gone. My first thought, hire this man. Would you want to talk to him? Now think about that. You don't know his educational background. You don't know his degree. You don't know his technology experience. You don't know anything about him. But I tell you what you do know. You smell personal accountability. That's what this message is all about today. You don't smell victim thinking, procrastination, or blame. So I called him over. I asked him some questions. Come. I thought you didn't sell Coke products. We don't, sir. Well, where did this come from? A grocery store around the corner, sir. Who paid for it? Well, I did, sir. Just a dollar out of my tip money. Then I asked him this question. You ready? Come on, how did you have time to go get it? You've been so busy. He says, he straightens up, he smiles. He goes, oh, I didn't go get it, sir. I sent my manager. Right now, would you all turn to Rick and say these words? Get me a Diet Coke. Turn to somebody in this room right now. It's so much fun. Get me a Diet Coke. What a great feeling. That's empowerment. A minute later, right then, I asked him the naive question of the month. You know what I said to him? Why? Why would you do this for me? Guess what he said? He summed up all selling and service in one question. He said, pardon me, sir. Didn't you want one? Oh, well, can I write that down? Get the client exactly what they want or need, whether we offer it through Nationwide or not. That's pure service. That's how you got to this meeting, isn't it? It was time to leave. How many of you had left him a really good tip? Yeah, so as my quarters bounced across the bar. I came back a month later. I couldn't forget him. I asked for him. His name was Jacob Miller. Dave, you love his last name? I do. I walked into the lobby. The hostess greets me, and I said, one for non-smoking, please. And I'd like to sit in Jacob Miller's section. And she says, oh, I'm sorry. Jacob is no longer. My mind went crazy. And I'm thinking thoughts like, no, you didn't really lose my own personal server. You lost a guy who did not point at upper management and say, when is management going to create the products the customer wants? You lost a guy who did not whine and say, why are we so busy in here? My life is so stressed out. You lost a guy who did not say, why can't the customer read the policy / menu? How could they lose that guy? Let's go back. One for Jacob Miller section, please. And she said, oh, I'm sorry, Jacob is no longer. And I interrupted her and I said, oh, no, you lost him? And she says, oh, no, sir, we didn't lose him. We promoted him to management. And I said, management? What a waste. All that productivity gone. How many of you agree with that, huh? You know what? Here's what's not a waste. The win that Jacob got that day has nothing to do with money. I think he went home that night, looked in the mirror. I think he was able to say this. I like this guy. Looking in the mirror and saying, I'm really proud of you because today you practice personal accountability. You avoided whining, blaming, victim thinking, and pointing fingers and procrastination. You rose above and practiced personal accountability with a heart of service. You never asked, when are we going to get more tools and better systems? You simply asked, how can I serve this person with what I have right now? I want to be more like Jacob Miller. He's a hero for me.